shoes, I'm picking a slack now. Spend most of my days thinking if I would ever live outside the background. Now I pull strings, they out to get me another day, another man down. I'm picking my shoes, I'm picking the litter, I'm pushing the limit, I'm picking a slack now.
The glitters ain't gold, look around where we roam through. In the land of the broken, it's a lot we was prone to. Quicksand was engulfing, but intact with my soul. But this patch, I'm evolving, searching for solitude. While most fold, I'm calm and composed. Stop the politicking with no, they voters is froze. I'm off the hit with the 50s, I can't be product and system. I pray to God, know he listen, won't seal my fate with some kisses. Nah, cause we ain't got time to keep off our toes. The type of vigor make you consider throwing the towel. I'm in the mood to make y'all remember going to proud. Sharpen my sword, declaring a war on foes and cows, yeah. So pass me the torch, thrones and crowns. It's the voice of the future tonight, rooster sounds. The bronze age forever, that's a God-given level. On a high like crescendo, what my mind stay resemble.
Missing my girl, I ain't seen her in days. What can I say? I'm out in the bay trying to get paid.
Yeah.
Look what I made. Thousands of people are knowing this J.
No.
I never change. Can't put myself back in that minimum wage.
Gotta keep balling, this crunch time.
Yeah.
Eating these rappers is lunchtime. You the man, only sometimes. End your career with a punchline. The industry coming to the front lines. I'm in the mind. Getting money in my bloodline. Talking on my mind.
Keep with a real. Don't want to talk of a name by the dip.
Nah.
Made a name for me real quick. Ain't gon' stop till my net worth millions. Going to school, I drop down. They try to read when I drive with a top down. Get me on stage, I rock out. Every day money can't break, no timeouts. Change up quick, they sign up. Tryna hear my line now. Thinking I'm come find out. 1v1, you dust like a wideout. Studio been my hideout. Can't shed tears, mama, ain't no cry now. On me, gonna blind out. Get in the team, gotta pass your tryouts.
Yeah, yeah. Booming this like Metro. Groupies on me, that's fine, don't sweat those.
Been on keeping my head strong. My dog ain't talk about Petco. Brand new ones, they retros. Live fast, die on set, my headstone.
Yeah.
I been grown. You ain't getting money, yeah. Been frank in the friend zone.
Got,
I ain't never switched up in a family.
Never.
Be talking to that at me. Gotta watch my wrist, that's classy.
Yeah.
I'm a dog to a she nasty. Then I'm about she me. My mama proud she had me. Can't let nobody surpass me.
No.
I move to the back like an athlete. Got a little buzz, but these zippers don't chance me.
What?
Just take a look at my rap sheet. Independent, many she can't stand me.
Can't.
Won't stop till I got me a Grammy, a crib with a leg and a whip for my granny.
Yeah.
I ain't never had me, no plan B. Look at me now, got a problem, get at me.
We're just a stone's throw from the Delaware River. We've got some water to contend with ourselves. A steady rain falling at Lincoln Financial Field. Today it's week 3 and we've got a good one in store as it'll be the Carolina Panthers taking on the Philadelphia Eagles. Two weeks have come and gone. It's off to week 3, and we're underway on EA Sports. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. Well, a dangerous return man showing it here. Still going past the 30. But it will be an excellent return here all the way down inside the 25-yard line. What a play.
As the excitement continues to swirl after that return, if I'm the offensive coordinator, I'm thinking about keeping that excitement going. Already in scoring position, I've got to take some shots at the end zone right now.
Here we go, here we go.
Opposite,
And they'll run on first down with Hubbard. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of two, and it brings up second down.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going, and then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Here's a second and eight. Here is Young. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
Out of the gun, here's the give to Hubbard. Take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Chuba Hubbard, his second rushing touchdown on the year. And the Panthers need just three plays to go down and take the early lead. Footing always a concern, but the extra point's up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Johnson won't return this, and the football will come out to the 25. Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Start this drive out on the ground. And a short pickup to about the 27. It'll be second down. Well, this defense for the Panthers, very strong last week as they helped their squad improve to 2-0 on the young season.
It was a little bit enlightening talking with the defensive coordinator about their performance last week, because the feeling was that it was a good, solid performance. They did what they needed to do to get the job done and get the win, but definitely a few lapses that they're looking to correct.
On the end around, here comes Smith. Oh, he's got some breathing room. Now he's loose at the 40. Inside the 20, Devontae Smith. Touchdown! Devontae Smith, his second touchdown on the season. And the Eagles are able to strike back quickly with an opening touchdown of their own. And oh, he missed it. No good. And they'll remain down by a point. Back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. And hold on here, because on that last run, it looks like we have a player who was shaken up. While they come out and take a look at him, we will step aside for just a moment. Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. On the counter, this is Hubbard to the 43, second down.
A big part of a middle linebacker's job is being able to take on blocks and then go make plays. But the best ones, they have those big guys in front of them playing defensive line to hold blockers off of them and allow them to flow sideline to sideline and make the big hits.
Second down, Young. short throw underneath to Hurst. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. It's his first catch, and it'll be good for 15 and a first down.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Straight ahead with Hubbard. What a nice burst there as he'll take this inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this a little bit of math here. Four plays, three first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. First down, they'll stay on the ground with Hubbard. And they're knocking on the door now. As a good run there, going to take this to about the 10-yard line. 46 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just five times.
Well, they're making a real first quarter statement with a run game, no doubt.
For those who remember old school football, running it, establishing things, seeing backs find holes, get through them, they've got to like what they're seeing from this unit so far. Right
now. Take it across from him. That's touchdown. Chuba Hubbard with his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year, as his guys are able to extend their lead. Some good running there at the end of the drive. He had the burst that set up the first and goal, and then one play later, he's in the end zone.
Brandon, what I liked about that sequence is I'm not sure who made the play call, but they understood the situation, understood the momentum. A nice hard-charging run, give it right back to him, and let him cap things off.
Johnson won't return this, and the football will come out to the 25. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit. So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now, first and 15 following the delay of game. Hurts sets up to throw it. This one complete down the field to Goddard. A solid stiff arm. A big play there on the catch and run. 71 yards. Well, that didn't take long. One play, and we're already looking at a first and goal situation. So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit. The delay of game, a costly one, as they're backed up five for first and goal. Now it's Smith. And that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line.
He was brought down by DJ Johnson.
Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. And that is incomplete. A lot of force down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already.
Here comes third and goal. From the gun, it's Hurts. This is caught. Touchdown, Eagles. AJ Brown, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Eagles are back within a couple of the lead. On that connection, it looked like they maybe had some pre-play communication. Maybe one of them noticed an area that was open to the defense to get the pass to.
When you put the time in, sometimes you have that great silent communication that you just noticed right there, because the best quarterback-receiver combos in the NFL, they know how to make those adjustments at the line of scrimmage when they see something pre-planned.
Gun with a PAT, and the lead is cut to one at 14-13. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Well, this offense looks like they have a little extra pep in their step as they take the field here for drive number three, because remember, Charles, drives one and two both ended in the end zone.
Yeah, right now they just got to be careful not to lean into overconfidence, because every drive has a life of its own. But I like the way that they've started, the way that they're going about doing things right now. They've got a chance for that third consecutive touchdown, and that would be a crushing blow to the defense.
A give up the middle, Hubbard. And a good burst there gets him seven up to midfield.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Now second and three. The play fake, now Young. And he'll be hit as he releases it. But now fall incomplete.
The defense is certainly coordinated. Doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front. Helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. Young now from the 50. He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles 33. A nice pickup of 17 yards.
I'm not sure that that was necessarily a safety valve or a check down throw on third down. Sometimes just try and find the open guy and get him the ball. He did exactly that and found a way to pick up a first down.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And the return across midfield and to the 46-yard line.
All these years we've been watching the game, I start to get the sense that whenever it rains out, those guys who have to touch the ball and carry it, they're extremely resentful about that weather.
Yeah, I'm just happy I'm not resentful that we have a roof over our heads. I know that much.
Yeah, maybe we won't fumble our play sheets here as we just saw the fumble happen on the field.
They'll run it now with Smith. And a strong run there as he'll take this all the way down to the 45. It's It's an Eagles first down on a gain of 11.
Well, that play looks familiar because we saw them working on it in practice this week. And for linemen trying to block on this play, they love when they get the defense moving in one direction. And when they try and change directions, it's a lot easier to pick them up and ward them off.
Off the play fake. Here's Hurts. Wide open is Watkins. He's got it. And he doesn't quite make it. Taking it with an eyelash. Dropped at the one. It's a gain of 34. Now, they lulled them to sleep there, so to speak. That was all set up by the running game, wasn't it?
Another example of what all offensive coordinators tell us. When the running game's operating, it really opens up the playbook. And that's when they hit them with the play action. And you can see the defenders rushing towards the line of scrimmage, then scrambling back trying to cover. Couldn't get there in time.
Well scripted. They had the big running play, now the big passing play. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Only a yard on the keeper, and it'll be second down.
But not much on that run, Charles.
That they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mark that down for a win in the defense.
And he's in for the Eagles touchdown. It's a 1 yard touchdown run, and the Eagles have taken the lead.
So, Charles, that's three touchdowns on three drives, and it's just been an offensive barrage so far.
Great word, partner, using barrage right there. I'm going to add another word, if you don't mind. How about perfection? No surprise that they're leading right now. Absolute dominance throughout this ball game.
Elliott Good on the extra point, and that'll make this a six-point game. Now, after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go.
Charles, you got to think the number one goal here is ball security. Remember, last drive, they coughed it up. Then they allowed the touchdown, and now they're trailing on the scoreboard.
Boy, the way you described it makes me think that that one actually hurt them three times. The fumble cost them potential points. Then they watched their opponent get a touchdown off of the fumble. And third, they lost the lead as a result. Really tough sequence right there. I don't think coaches have to remind them to hold on to the football. They've just got to find a way to get it done.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
Sidney Brown in on the tackle.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. The free safety roaming all the way up to the line of scrimmage to make that stop.
How about his ability to trust his eyes and figure out it was not a pass play and go fast towards the line of scrimmage in order to make that tackle?
Young. Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts. It's just their first, so we'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. That is caught. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A real letdown defensively. That was third and a bundle, but they allow the conversion. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down. And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game. It has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try to pick up another first down.
And they'll take this one down about the 30. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
convert the first down.
Young on third down. Well, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off by Reed Blankenship. Oh, they try lateral on the return, and now the ball's loose. But it looks like one of the DBs has it. And he'll return this one just shy of midfield to the 49. And partner, I know hindsight's always 20-20, but man, just in general, those laterals, they can be so risky, and we see the risk that can be involved right there.
And you just have to know, and we've seen it because we've been at a lot of practices. It's not something that's practiced very often.
And this is
just not running from all.
Devontae Smith. He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Eagles are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Hurts will throw. And he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by two more. Touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive.
Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, this is exactly why you practice a two-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
So how about this for a change in field position? From inside the 10, here's first down on the other side of the field. Meanwhile, the throw by Young was knocked away and incomplete. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
He gets this one to Hubbard, complete. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. It's a gain of 34.
What a game he's having. They've not been able to stop him or even slow him down. He's got two touchdowns already. That could have been a third. He's got the secondary coach asking people for answers. Can you help me out? Because we are not slowing him down.
Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. So they're backed up to the 3-yard line, second and goal. Hubbard is into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown.
He finishes off the drive with a touchdown run, Charles. Remember, he also had a catch on this drive as well.
And that's what running backs want to be in today's NFL, a complete back. Three downs, stay on the field, run it and catch it, and he gets it done.
Pinheiro's extra point up and good.
And they're within seven now at 28-21.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And with a 7-point lead, they'll likely look to take this to the locker room and not really press the issue. Right at the 40.
And while we're seeing more and more of these plays come from the college game into the NFL, and that one, it was run with great success. How about the evolution of the offensive linemen? We're seeing less and less big guys who can't move, and more guys who are a lot more mobile and can get out in front of that type of a play.
He's going deep for Brown. And this is...
Wow.
And he's in for the touchdown.
How did they get that done?
That's a pretty quick response to that last touchdown drive, and it seemed like they maybe given up momentum. Not so fast.
No, not at all, because they end up pushing the lead up once again, and you're exactly right. Thought momentum might have been shifting. Instead, they grabbed old Mo, didn't let him get to the opposite sideline.
Two quarters down, two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
I'm sort of playing trigger. I knew he was going to be on soon because I've seen his name before on it. Sorry, that's my brother discussing. Sorry, that's fucking bullshit. Fucking trade.
Welcome back, halftime.
Throw it up at the end of the fucking half just to fucking be able to come
back. Charles Davis, I'm Brandon
Gordon.
We're
half up fucking
forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in
the
second
half.
And the fair catch signaled for and taken, so they'll begin this third quarter from their 25-yard line.
Yeah, I'm waiting to hear back from Josh about playing today.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. But Charles, for them, pretty good first half on the ground. They had some success running the ball in quarters one and two, and they've got the lead. Now a chance to expand upon that lead here with their first drive in the third quarter.
Yeah, believe it or not, you and I have noticed that this great game of football has shifted towards pass first, run second. So for me, it's really nice to see some of these teams keeping the ground game as a big component of their offense, and it's working pretty well for them now. And let's face it, they can continue to do damage with it. And in addition, it sets up the pass game really well for them, too.
They'll wind up losing three, and now it's third down.
And that's what this defense is going to need to do more in the second half. Good pressure that time, forces some indecision in the backfield. He's going to wind up being taken down for a nice loss.
Here comes third down at seven. Here's Hurts to throw. Flush to his right.
God damn. Oh my god, I knew what was fucking coming because he keeps running it. And it fucking wouldn't let me fucking get through. I'm sorry, that's fucking bullshit running the same fucking play every other three quarters.
15-yard gain there as they look to improve this 14-point lead from the 32 now. Here's first and 10. Hurts.
Oh my god. Kid, you're becoming a fucking liability right now. Why are you fucking just choosing not to run and fucking bump on here?
32 yards, and the Eagles have moved out in front by three touchdowns.
Yeah.
Elliott on for the extra point.
Fucking German Chin just keeps fucking running with fucking Devontae in the fucking middle and having a fucking play. Fucking deep post. Fucking keep
now
keep
after the
burnt.
Touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone.
I gotta look after this fucking game and figure out who the fuck my head keeps this
on. Net gain of one there.
That motherfucker be getting out. He's gotta be a fucking rookie. Alright, come on. We're down fucking 21 now.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Now a first down throw for Young.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I think he had to alert that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really.
Second and 10 now. Third quarter action from Philadelphia, PA. Young's throw taken in by Collins. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead.
It's time to give more credit there to the defense. Because it was a drag route, and he ran a little shallow as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Now a shot taken on third. It's going to be
success last week throwing the football, but that hasn't translated to this week. But with his team behind, I don't expect him to back off. I expect him to keep firing.
So it looks like the offense isn't going anywhere. They're going to go for it on fourth and seven. They'll try and throw for it here. Looking for Thielen, but it's intercepted. The safety, Terrell Edmund, and I think the ball's out.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout.
I one play fucking changed the name of this game.
Throwing is Hurts. Left with no option here but to throw it away.
I think we can all understand what they're thinking right now. They take over the ball in field goal range after the turnover, so they've got that in their hip pocket. But they've got to go for the end zone and turn this into a bigger point. They're thinking is a touchdown is really what they should get from starting here. Getting 3 points at the end of this drive, that would feel disappointing.
Second down, here's Hurts. And Goddard's got it. Touchdown, Hurts. A 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Eagles are able to widen their advantage. So remember now, this was all set up by... 2 plays later, they're already in the end zone.
Yeah, partner, funny how it works like that, huh? That's a momentum swing amusement park style. Your defense comes off the field, bouncing, grooving, they're fired up, and it carries over to the other side of the ball.
Elliott good on the extra point. And increase their lead to 28.
Man, was that fucking 28?
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Now this will be returned from deep in the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, why, right?
Bro.
Score, that's going to be intercepted. It's N'Kobe Dean with a pick, and he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line.
Nothing, just cut Randall Gregory. Patriots traded for Jesse Jackson.
The way things have gone in this one, the running
game
from
the Chargers.
That's not been too bad for them.
They were a 6th-round pick. We got JC and a fucking 7th in 2025 draft.
In motion right is Brown. A fake on the Jets sweep.
Well, they lost the rookie for the season. He's out for the season.
Get another third quarter
touchdown to add on to that lead. Elliott did with a PAT, and the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. Now after the touchdown,
that was just kind of like a ridiculous blowout. Out of fucking nowhere, did you see?
This is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And he returns this to the 22.
I shouldn't have went away from running the fucking ball. I mean, I think it's just this.
This Carolina offense at the line ball. Ready to go. Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. A win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles, but I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something.
Win 2 and 1 now.
Until the clock runs out. But, Brandon, we've been around this game a long time. This is an outlier. You don't get many blowouts like this no matter how the game looks on paper going in. This one has turned out to be everyone's worst nightmare realized.
Meanwhile, the throw here is complete. They get a leg back on that. It's the third game.
It's a nice completion of the run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it's so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. Because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? On play action, Young. He'll air one out deep for Mingo. And this is dropped. It's incomplete. Big game on the sights, but he did not reel it in.
And this is a situation where, as a head coach, you're just saying, what else could go wrong? Let's get it all out of our system, please. This has been a sloppy game throughout. The execution has been lacking. A lot of mistakes, both mental and physical. And here's a big play that goes by the wayside.
And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. A big roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert. They only needed that 1 yard going for it on fourth. I got to be honest. I thought they were going to stay on the ground. They surprised me. Did they surprise you?
I'm with you on that one. I thought they'd find a way to create some type of a power run and try and pick up the first down. But they decided keep the ball in the hands of the guy who could throw it, and it paid off.
Yeah, that decision paid off indeed. I'll tell you, far from ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. First and 10. And boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Ready, go. Second and 10. Ready. Young now. He finds his man complete. It's Hubbard. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
Well, I mean, look, obviously there's no 20 or 30 point play in that playbook, but they can try to end things here on a positive note despite trailing big, and that looks like what they're trying to do here by pushing the ball downfield.
Well, let me go with the heavy cliche then, partner. Just control what you can control.
Oh,
and what you can control here is how their final plays develop.
They'll wind up losing a full 10 yards on the play, and it'll make this a second and long. Young working out of the gun. Then he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here. At this point, down big, you have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, not get the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
Ninth play of the drive now on third and a country.
Yeah, Trayvon doing the same shit.
They go play action. Young. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles 20-yard line. A real letdown defensively. That was third and a bundle, but they allow the conversion. From the red zone now, Young. Flushed out right. Throw right side, taking
it. Should Nico Collins?
Touchdown, Panthers. Nico Collins, a 20-yard touchdown. And the Panthers get a small measure of revenge as they
come to the first touchdown of the season.
Man, he just ran a terrific route. Extremely hard to defend when it's run that precisely and the ball's delivered that accurately.
Pinheiro's extra point up and good.
Dante's been balling for you over there.
The Carolina kick team is out there ready.
Nico's really like wide receiver 4 for me. Nico Collins. He's wide receiver 4. Because I got Eagles, Nico, and that rookie that I'm building.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive.
But I'm sure Thielen's going to retire after this year, so.
What we're looking at on the scoreboard, but they've scored on 3 consecutive drives, and I'm sure that they would like to
get that score. Yeah, I'm going to get started.
And things have gotten that way in the NFL, haven't they, partner? Because
I don't get fucking momentum. You know, just get off all the fucking blocks in the way.
But now, people continue to accelerate. But we'll see what they decide to do as they come out for this one. But the way that this game has gone, they've got to be awfully happy with their execution overall.
Right back to him on first down. And he's fortunate to get anything from that. Give him a yard up to the 49. This defense starting to buckle down when they need to, and right now they're winning this fourth quarter, losing the game, but they're winning in the fourth quarter.
And what a fine line it is about what they're trying to get done, because they're down, so they obviously need the football, need a score, but they can't be so aggressive as to give up their edge, their gaps, and have the offense hit them with a big play.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And just 1 yard here from the 49 to the 50.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations
where there'd be
extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 38-yard line. Now we'll get a stoppage here as it appears we've got an Eagle slow to get up. The medical staff will attend to him, and we will step aside.
Oh, that dude, yeah. I ended up beating him. Yeah, that was an ugly ass fucking game.
Boy, has it been fun to watch this offense operate quite the display, and now they look to polish it off. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play.
Oh, that's a thing of beauty right there. Look at how quick those blockers fired off the line once
the
ball was snapped.
That
was an O-line on a mission, all in sync, and the defense is lucky that play only picked up 5 yards.
You see that shit about the national emergency signal shit today?
So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they look to salt this one away.
That shit about.
Now second and 5.
Unless your phone is off, it's going to still alert you. The only way to avoid it is your phone be turned off or your phone be
airplane.
And it's going to hit TVs, phones, computers, all that shit.
He didn't like that option at all. Did a nice job saving yardage by throwing that one away.
On the carry, here's Smith.
Oh my fucking god, I clicked off by accident. I knew what the fuck he was running and I accidentally fucking clicked off. And of course, fucking Steven Henderson gets fucking juiced. New Year's on that stupid ass fucking end around. He ran all fucking games.
Okay, we're still in the playoff hunt. We're not out of it at 0-3. But the other
sorry,
part, too, at least a doubt about your system.
What's going
on? Elliott good on the extra point. And
And this one was making the playoffs this year, really.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone.
And he's going to win in my fucking division, but I'm going to make the fucking play. The end zone, not a good one. Fucking Breeze, the fucking Marlin hasn't fucking lost shit. And do my fucking stack of loss, so I don't get the reach first. Oh, I know. We were all 2-0 coming into this week. Me, Kelvin, and Marlin. Where we stand right now, I'm 2-1 now. The Bucks is 0-2. Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things. Sorry ass bitch, that's what you get for not clicking on.
They've had several turnovers. You would have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily.
Fucking Chuba Hubbard's had a fucking day. In relief for fucking, Miles Sanders. Because Miles is hurt. You got 3 fucking touchdowns with Chuba.
Time out. This they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Off the play fake, Young. And this is caught inside the 5. And somewhat of a measure of revenge as he's in for the touchdown. But they still trail big time.
He'll take it, but he won't be able to smile about it.
A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play he would have made as a rookie. Because usually your rookie season is a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to a second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
Man, I seen this shit on TikTok last night, and I may be gonna fucking try it one day. Fucking air fried mac and cheese. That shit looked good as fuck. I may end up getting the shit and trying it one day. That shit looked good as fuck.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. They're in control here as they start first and 10.
And maybe his momentum shift. Yeah, momentum. That two-game losing streak. Looking left side, he's got a man. That's Watkins. And take this to the other side. All right. Weird.
He got 29 yards at time.
Partner, I have to tell you, just one word keeps coming to mind from watching them this afternoon. And that's impressive. They have been impressive from the opening kickoff. And they haven't let up here even into the fourth quarter.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. This is caught inside the 15. The Eagles gonna take the first of their timeout.
Jump that shit. I'm gonna fucking dish one time to 70 up. 63-36. He's on the 13 yard line. And he just got 70. Motherfuckers just get bullshit. Just fit it right in between 3 fucking defenders to fucking Devontae's head in that door. It is what it is. That's my first loss this season.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And solid field position here to start as they get this out to the 40-yard line.
Even after that big-time return, it's not looking great for them today. But if nothing else, even if the miracle doesn't happen, they can turn to this play and say, hey, we can move forward. Maybe it's a building block for the rest of the season.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go.
Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, that's a good way of pointing things out, because now it's not a total loss, because as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually...
What the fuck? I've never seen them do that shit before.
They were just out personnel. They were going up against a
team. I went back and watched your stream of what you were talking about with the kickoff. I ain't never seen them do that shit. Yeah. It's just weird.
A play fake. Now Young. He's got Mingo. They'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark him down at the 9. A gain of 39 that time.
Well, this game has certainly had no shortage of offense. Both teams have been revved up from the start. And here's yet another big play. Boy, both defenses have just got to be dragging out there because they've been run ragged throughout.
Here we go. The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. Throwing Young.
Yeah, I've seen it.
His pass caught at the 4. Oh, wait, hold everything.
I ain't got to show you up right now, but I've seen it the last time.
Seemingly silly with 1 second remaining in this game.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Oh my God. And he about to get 77. I threw a fucking pick trying to fucking score again. And he's gonna take it back to 6. That game changed on a, I tried to run the triple option shit